Welcome to OFAR. In this tutorial, I'll be guiding you on how to assemble the Milsbo glass cabinet from IKEA. For this build, you need a Phillips screwdriver, a level, and an Allen key that IKEA gives you. You can also use a drill with a Phillips bit if you want to speed up the assembly process. So the first step is to grab these four legs and four adjustable feet, then screw in each adjustable foot into each leg. Now put these four legs into this orientation. These two legs will have the bigger holes located in the corners, while the other two will have these right angle lines. Also grab these two longer metal bars, and make sure that the holes I pointed to are facing inwards like this. Then connect each leg like this. Now grab these two smaller metal bars and make sure that the holes are facing inwards. Then connect them as shown. Next, grab 8 smaller screws, and using the Allen key, screw them into these 8 holes. Now grab this piece, and make sure that the ends that are sticking out in the corners are located here. Then place this piece like this, and also grab 4 of the smaller screws. Secure the 4 screws into these 4 holes. Then grab 2 more small screws, and screw them into these 2 holes. Next, grab 4 of these long corner pieces and put them into this orientation. These ends that I pointed to are the bottoms. Also grab 4 of the longer screws. Then secure each long corner piece with 1 screw. The whole process will look like this. Now grab this piece and make sure that this cutout is located here. Then place this piece on like this. Next, grab this long piece and make sure that it's in this orientation. The two holes that I pointed to will be located closer to the bottom. Then slide the bottom in like this and grab one small screw. Then secure the small screw into this hole. Now grab this top piece and make sure that this hole is located here. Then place this piece on like this. Next, grab four of these small screws and secure them into these four holes. This time though, don't secure them in fully. Then grab this small screw, and again, don't fully secure it into this hole. Now turn the structure 180 degrees. Next, grab a piece of glass, it doesn't matter which one, and put it in like this. First, come in on an angle and push in the top. Then, push the bottom in after. You can ask someone to help you hold the piece of glass so it doesn't fall over. Now grab another piece of glass and put it in the same way. Next, grab these three plastic pieces. As you can see, they're a bit different than the other 12. Also grab three small screws, and you'll be securing the three plastic pieces into these three holes. The whole process will look like this. Just make sure when screwing in the screws, you don't apply too much pressure, as the glass can bend and break. Now grab another piece of glass and put it in as shown. Then grab 4 corner plastic pieces and 4 small screws. Then secure each plastic piece with 1 screw into these 4 spots. The whole process will look like this. Next, grab the last piece of glass and put it in a show. And again, grab 4 corner plastic pieces and 4 small screws. Then secure each plastic piece with 1 screw into these 4 holes. Then grab 4 more corner plastic pieces and 4 small screws. Then secure each plastic piece with 1 screw into these 4 holes. They'll be secured into the middle section of the cabinet. The end product will look like this. Now double check that the pieces of glass are fully in and secure these 4 screws. Then go to the back and secure this screw. Next, grab these two glass doors and put them into this orientation. Just make sure that these two pairs of holes are located here. Also grab these two locking mechanisms and four longer screws. Then secure each locking mechanism like this. Now grab these two metal pins and insert them as shown. Next, you'll be attaching this door. Grab this metal pin and attach the door. You'll be inserting the metal pin like this. Now make sure this gap that I pointed to is going to be located closer to the top of the cabinet. Also grab another metal pin and insert it as shown. Then grab these two handles and four small screws. Attach each handle with two screws like this. Now put your glass cabinet against your intended wall. You can also clean any smudge marks at this point if you want. Then check that your doors are level. If they're not, grab a level and adjust all 4 feet accordingly. Now if you want to secure a cabinet to drywall, grab these two brackets and two small screws. Then secure both brackets like this. Unfortunately, IKEA doesn't give you any wall anchors or screws, so you're going to have to buy your own. I've done these steps already in another video, so if you want to see how to secure these brackets to drywall properly, I'll leave a link with a timestamp in the description below. Then grab three glass shelves and carefully place them on like this. So now grab the keys and check that the doors can lock. First close this door and then slide both locking mechanisms like this. Then close the other door and use the key to lock the cabinet. If you followed all these steps, then you shouldn't have any issues. So you now have a fully assembled Milsbo glass cabinet from IKEA. Hopefully this tutorial helped you out.